The fourth one is when the top idea is poorer, then the gas can pass through the spaces between the oxide particles, and again the whole of the metal is converted into oxide, or technically it is corroded. So this is how the gases affect the metal which is exposed to them. But the most prevalent corrosion is due to the oxygen or oxidative corrosion, and the metal says that the gas and the metal atoms will come in contact for the formation of the compound. And the third is when the molten liquid, when the molten metal or the liquid, hot liquid, it moves on a metal or alloy, metal or alloy. It either reacts with the metal or it goes into the metal or alloy affecting it. Or then one example which has been quoted in the book is that of the liquid sodium which is used as a coolant in the nuclear reactor. When the liquid sodium passes through the tubes of the metal, it reacts with the tubes of the metal at higher temperature. So this is how the dry corrosion takes place. And now come to the stress corrosion, which is here. Then I will discuss with you the protective